सिर्फ तुमसे प्यार है, हमको सिर्फ तुमसे प्यार है. That was the shot I first gave in my life. I also wanted to have a film which had adventure, which had horses, which had the mountains.
And I love Betal.
Hi guys, welcome to Box Office India. This is Anita, and today in conversation I have Mr. Bobby Deol with us. Hi. Welcome to
Hi,
Box
Anita,
Office India.
How are you doing?
Thank you so much for having me again.
I'm good.
I'm so happy that we've been meeting like this. I just wish ki hum zyada bahar milte, matlab aise nahi.
Phone ke through. आजकल का यही आज का नया जमाना है, आज यही आजकल करना पड़ता है. एटलीस्ट वी कैन कम्युनिकेट लाइक दिस.
या आई नो. सो या फर्स्टली कांग्रेचुलेशंस ऑन लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. ओके, आपकी क्लास ऑफ 83 हिट हो गई, आपका शो हिट हो गया, आपका 25 इयर्स हो गया, तो बड़ा सेलिब्रेशन तो बनता है. आपने आश्रम का अकेले अकेले पार्टी कर लिया, दिस इज नॉट फेयर.
हाँ, अकेले अकेले ही करना पड़ता है, क्या करें. आजकल तो टाइम ऐसा हो गया, नहीं तो आप शो अगर समय ठीक था होता तो शायद एमएक्स पे बड़ी पार्टी रखते. लेकिन आई एम सो हैप्पी दैट शो इतना सक्सेसफुल रहा है कि व्हाट मोर, इट्स बेटर देन अ पार्टी आई थिंक.
देयर आर थ्री सेलिब्रेशंस राइट, सो हाउ हैव यू प्लान्ड दिस सेलिब्रेशन, लाइक 25 इयर्स इन द इंडस्ट्री एंड देन टू बिग
I'm just very grateful that after 25 years, again, this new chapter in my life has given me such amount of appreciation and the success of both my projects. It is just overwhelming. It is just amazing that, 25 saal bahut lamba samay hota hai industry mein rehne. You know, I've been in this industry for 25 years. पर पता भी नहीं, मुझे तो लगता भी नहीं कि 25 साल हो गए हैं. मैं जब मुझे कोई पूछता है तो मुझे लगता है हाँ यार 25 साल हो गए हैं. पर it has been a wonderful journey. I mean it has not been a perfect journey, but it has been a wonderful journey. And I am very lucky and very blessed for all the love I have got in all these years. All my fans have stood by me, and now I have made even more fans. So I am very grateful to all of them.
Bobby, because I knew I was going to interview you, put a quest. We wanted to do a thirsty comment with you, okay? Which I am going to do post this interview. But mostly, all your fans have just messaged and said, we are so happy to see Bobby back. We are so happy with the show. They love the show. It was all about all the love that you could get through Ashram, you have got it. What do you have to say to those fans? Those loyal 25 years of fans that you have?
क्या मेरी ताकत वही है, उनका प्यार ही तो मेरी ताकत है, और मैं क्या कह सकता हूँ. इट्स जस्ट अमेजिंग, यू नो, इट्स ओवरवेलमिंग. इट इज जस्ट अ ब्यूटीफुल मोमेंट इन माय लाइफ वेयर इतने फैंस हैं मेरे. उन लोग इतना चाहते थे कि मैं आगे बढ़ूं अपनी करियर में और फिल्में करूं, और उन्हें पता है कि मैं कोशिश कर रहा हूं, और उन लोग सब मेरी मेहनत पे उन्हें बहुत क्या बोलते थे, प्राउड ऑफ मी. एंड इट मेक्स मी फील सो नाइस, यू नो, इट मेक्स मी फील सो अमेजिंग, यू नो, टू हैव सो मच लव. यू नो, आई जस्ट फील वेरी वेरी ब्लेस्ड, यू नो, इट्स सच एन अमेजिंग फीलिंग.
सो आई वुड लाइक टू टेक यू डाउन योर मेमोरी लेन. आई वांट यू टू रिमेंबर योर फर्स्ट डे ऑफ शूट. हाउ वाज इट फॉर बरसात? How was it? What do you remember about the entire shoot? And tell me everything about it.
So when I started my career, when I first started shooting, it was Shekhar Kapoor who was my director.
Yeah.
And मुझे आज भी याद है पहला दिन जब शूटिंग का था. एक फैक्ट्री का सेट लगा था, पुरानी फैक्ट्री जो बंद पड़ी है, और वहाँ की जो एक सीढ़ियाँ एक तरफ से आ रही है नीचे, तो मुझे वहाँ से चल के नीचे आना था, और नीचे उतर कर मुझे बस स्माइल करनी थी. And I was so nervous. एक तो सीढ़ियों से उतरना, ऊपर से, you know, you're so new to everything and you're so conscious about everybody around you because you're just starting off, you know, it's like you're not used to it. So I was very nervous that day, and that was the shot I first gave in my life as an actor, as my launch pad. But sad part is 27 दिन के बाद में वो shooting जब खत्म हुई तो second schedule के पहले ही शेखर कपूर को offer आ गया Hollywood से Bandit Queen के लिए. So he had to choose between my film and that film, and then he chose that, and my dad respected his wishes because it was a big opportunity for him also. So we finally got Raj to direct the film, Raj Santoshi. So that's how we started again. And that's what happened.
But do you remember, did you have any image of how you wanted to make a debut? Did you have any plans of your own?
I was very obsessed with my brother's Beta. You know, I also wanted to have a film which had adventure, which had horses, which had the mountains. You know, because you look up to your brother and I love Beta. It's one of my favorite films. So I wanted my film to also be like that. But strangely, the subject we chose ended up me being a mountain boy, you know.
Yeah.
And so the whole place became like exactly like how I wish it would be. And I love the mountains. So shooting in Manali was so much fun. You know, it is a beautiful place. And so it was really exciting, you know, that I also got to ride the horses and I even rode a chariot. I still remember jab chariot ki sequence hone wala tha barsaat mein to papa aaye the especially Manali check karne ke liye chariot mazboot banaya hai nahi, kyunki he was worried because you know kabhi kabhi shooting ke time koi koi cheeze theek se banate nahi hai, wo kaam chalao banate hain. So he wanted to come and check everything and he rode the chariot himself to see if it's, you know, proper, and that's how we did it. You know. So
you also had a tiger costume.
Yeah, I had a tiger fight. I had a tiger fight. It was like Papa ne itni filmon mein tiger fights kiye the, aur I guess they thought mountain boy hai to sher ke saath ladai rakhenge to acha lagega. तो मुझे याद है हम इटली गए थे शेर के साथ लड़ाई कर शेर के साथ जो शूटिंग की थी हमने वहाँ पर एक 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 there's one person there who supplies animals for shooting to Hollywood and all these places. So he had a beautiful zoo, he had beautiful animals, you know, and we shot with the tiger and I was very nervous because you know if a dog bites you it hurts and if you imagine a tiger biting you he'll just pull your whole flesh out. But nice. I did that and it was exciting because you know it was like, see, the plan was to showcase my character, my personality, my capabilities in the one film. And that's how the project was written, you know, and that's how it was conceived. And that's why all these elements were put in it. So, uske baad mein hum seedha chale gaye England, wahan par ek jagah hai, Lake District. We went to shoot. My brother wanted to enhance my introduction sequence. We'd already finished shooting of the whole film, but we wanted to just add some more, you know, horse riding shots. And so when we were shooting that first shot, I broke my leg.
Yeah.
And so that shot, my first shot in the film, is my last shot of the shoot of the whole film.
Oh, and, okay.
I still have a rod in my leg, and but I'm just happy that I can walk, dance. I've had this rod in my leg for 25 years now. So yeah. So when I was shooting in Lake District, I first shot only. When I was galloping on the horse, I banged into another horse and I broke my leg. And I was lucky my brother was with me. And, you know, in fact, my leg broke so badly that he had to fly me from that small area town hospital because they gave up. They said they can't repair the leg. I had to fly down to London overnight and get my surgery done the next day. So it was thanks to my brother. I mean, he's like a father figure to me. He was there to take care of me. So that's how I began. And that's why when I started shooting for, I'd already signed Gup and I was already shooting for it. I'd already started shooting and I'd already shot for Duniya Haseeno Ka Mela. But afterwards, when I started shooting, then I couldn't move because my leg was broken and I couldn't still walk. I was in crutches. So that's why all my hand movements became, you know, very popular. They became like a signature movement of Bobby Deol because no one knew that because I couldn't really dance with my leg was broken. So ज़्यादातर वो गाना था ऊँचाइयाँ गहराइयाँ and all that and so I should do this and I should do this, you know, things like that.
But do you remember? I remember I read somewhere that you had to take the award, the best actor award, and you best, gave a beer.
I had got the best debutant. Best debut.
Right.
Award.
And you had to shoot a video and send, and you couldn't receive the award. Right?
Yeah,
you couldn't personally go and receive the award.
Because what happened was my leg didn't heal and I had to get another surgery done. And so when I got my second surgery done, the awards were going to happen. And Khalid Mohammed came to my hospital and at Breach Candy and I had to take, catch the award and take a picture.
Right. But also you missed out on those promotions for Barsaat. Did that, you know, make you feel bad? Because
not
you were hospitalized.
Actually, no. This happened after the film had released. My surgery happened in March next year. My movie released in October. So I had already finished with the release and everything. It's just that the awards happened after a few months. So that's how I was in the hospital at that time.
Right. So along with your dance, there was also one thing that became very famous and, you know, people were following. It was your hairstyle. The long hair. Do you miss those days of having long hair and, you know?
Yes, I still love long hair and I really enjoyed it. And I still, it's like, it's amazing, like in this industry, and there have been so many actors who've had long hair, but people always relate long hair to Bobby Deol.
Yes.
So it's quite a nice compliment. And abhi lockdown hai to mere bachcho ko main dono beto ko kehta rehta tha lambe kar lo baal, mante nahi the, sabko chote baal pasand hai, to abhi lockdown hai to sabke baal lambe ho gaye, to mujhe acha lagta hai, main dekhta hu mere beto ko, to they all, both of them have long hair, and they, you know, obviously your kids have some resemblance to how you used to look when you were young, so it's really nice to see both my boys with long hair.
Yes. So you tell me, which was your favorite movie? I know all your films will be your favorite, but ek ho rehta na that you have that feeling for that film, and which one was that?
It was Dil Lagi. I loved the character I got to play in Dil Lagi. I think it was such an amazing character to play at that point in my career. And my brother as a director brought the best out of me. So I think that film, it didn't do well at box office. Even though afterwards on satellite, people loved the film and they watched it.
Yeah.
And the music was amazing. So it's one of my favorite films.
And the songs were brilliant of the film. Actually, all
yes,
your film songs were very good.
Yes, I know. I was lucky to get good music in all my movies.
Yeah. Which is your favorite?
You know, obviously now it's 25 years to my movie, first movie. So I think Humko Sirf Tumse Pyar is one of my favorite tracks. You know, it's like I love shooting for it. I remember shooting in Manali and walking with a horse in a purple suit. And I just love that song.
Will it be wrong if I tell you to sing a little?
I'm bad at singing, I can't sing so well, but I can just say the line, Humko Sirf Tumse Pyar Hai, Humko Sirf Tumse Pyar Hai.
Superb, this will do. This is going to be my intro for sure.
Okay.
So, you know, you have worked with a lot of actresses. Who have been, who was the fun person on sets to work with? Who did you enjoy the most with?
I think I really enjoyed working with Preeti and Rani the most. You know, they were they were two people I've actually had arguments with. And I think that made our friendship even stronger. Because, you know, I also was new and, you know, so we've had arguments. And after the arguments, we became more friendlier. And it just broke the ice, I think. And I think I've really enjoyed working with both of them the most.
But do you sit with your kids and make them watch your films? Are they interested in watching your films? No.
I don't force them to watch my movies. They quietly watch it themselves, and they obviously, you know, for me, my father is everything. For my kids, I am everything. So they like everything you do. Definitely, they're honest about their opinion. They will tell me this film, they shouldn't have done it like this. They should have done it like this. Or this film, you should have done this character like a little like this. Or why did you do this scene like this? So they talk about it, things like that, but not in that detail because they're also a little shy talking to me about this.
Okay. So you tell me, in this 25 years, you had your ups and downs. What kept you going? What was that, you know, thing that kept you going?
I think, I knew my fans were always there. You know, because I remember when I was going through the bad phase, even when I used to step out, I used to meet my fans wherever I went. They would always say, "Hum taras rahe hain aapko screen par dekhne ke liye. Kab aayenge aap?" But they didn't know that the difficulties I was going through to get work. But eventually, all these things give me the motivation that I have fans. I need to just look after myself. you know, and move forward in life. And I think that's what it is. Like today, all my fans, the way they're appreciating me and the way they've stood by me is just amazing, you know. I'm so thankful to them for that.
One of your fans also asked me to ask you, when will you do an action film with Sunny?
I wish there was a script where we could both work together on an action film. It would be amazing, you know. But pata nahi abhi tak to koi script waisi mili nahi hai. Agar milegi to zarur karenge saath mein kaam.
Also, seeing three of you all together, Mr. Dharmendra sir, Sunny, and you, it's been everyone's, you know, joy. Like Yamla Pagla Diwana was brilliant, like to a different level. So do you think y'all can come back again with something?
Yeah, you definitely. Know? We're planning. We're working on things. Let's see now. Once they materialize, we'll talk about it. You know, it could be anything. It could be Apne Part 2. It could be YPD again. You know, I don't know. We're still working on scripts. And let's see, because the first Yamla Pagla Diwana was really well made. The second two were not so well made. So, I can hear your...
Yes. Your
pop. How is he doing?
He's doing fine.
So I think, I don't know, as you know, once everything gets concrete, we will talk about it. Right now, nothing. It's, you know, it's all in work in progress.
All right. You know, I wanted to ask you, what is there anything that you would like to change, or you're happy how your career has, you know, shaped up in this 25 years?
See, as I said, nothing is perfect. You know, I mean, you try to achieve. Being perfect is not an easy task, you know, but I just wish that definitely I'll make more mistakes in my life. We keep making mistakes and I hope I learn from them faster. That's all I'm trying and hoping that I learn from my mistakes faster than earlier in my life. You know, I took 3 years away from me to understand my mistakes and come back. So I just hope that I understand my mistakes from my mistakes and learn things better.
What next? What can your fans expect from you now after Ashram? Ashram 2?
I am definitely going to be working on season 2. Maybe next year beginning. Right now, the part 2 will come out, I think, after IPL. I don't know what the date is because I still don't have a date. But I'm working on some more projects. I am reading scripts. And aajkal kya hoga? You have to sign NDA. You can't talk about any of it.
Yeah.
Till the producer allows you. So definitely you'll see more of me. It might be more on OTT platform or on the silver screen, but definitely I'm meeting and talking to a lot of people.
Okay, thank you so much, Bobby, for doing this. It was really lovely having a conversation with you.
No, it wouldn't have been complete without your little darling down there.
Yes.
Hi, this is Bobby Deol and you're watching me on Box Office India. Please like, share and subscribe.